you're not eating the fish on its own, you are just eating the lipids of the fish. Hi and welcome to my channel. I am Tasos Koidis and I'm a university prof in food science and nutrition. In this channel, I'm helping you make better choices when it comes to food and to healthy eating. Omega-3 in the eggs, omega-3 in oils, omega-3 in cooking oils, omega-3 in oily fish. But how much do we know about these fats? Are they good for us? The scientific evidence, is it concrete? How much we should eat in our diets to get the benefits? Stick with me in this video to learn all that you need to know about the omega-3 intake in your diet. What are the omega-3 fats? Omega-3 fats are a group of unsaturated fats that can be found in some foods with numerous proven health benefits. There are different types of omega-3, but the most important are two. The alpha-linolenic acid, which is important for our body, but not essential for our body. And the long fatty acids, and these are the EPA and DHA. Now, these are found only in oily fish. Now, what happens is that your body cannot synthesize very efficiently ALA to EPA and DHA, alpha-linolenic acid to EPA and DHA. So you do have to eat the alpha-linolenic acid and EPA. Eating foods high in omega-3 could help you prevent heart diseases. In countries where people eat more oily fish, such as the Mediterranean or Japan, then you will have a better health, less risk of stroke compared to countries where people eat very little oily fish, such as the UK. So the omega-3 ALA, that's easier to find in most of the common things, for example, flaxseed, linseed, and so on. In a previous video, we talked about cooking oils, and then we said about the different types. So do watch this video if you want to learn more about it. But the fish oils, the EPA and DHA, these are the difficult ones to find. Oily fish, such as sardines, anchovies, mackerel, these are the good ones. But also herring, trout, and others. Now, white fish, pangasius, haddock, cod even, they are not rich in omega-3. That's the problem, because they don't have a lot of oil to begin with. Sorry, canned tuna, it doesn't have a lot of omega-3. But canned sardines, they do have omega-3. Make sure that you buy sustainably caught fish. Are you struggling to eat one or two portions of oily fish per week? Well, you're not alone. Many people are struggling. This is because either we don't know how to cook them, or it's not affordable, they're very expensive, or we just don't like them. Well, actually, the scientific evidence is that they are very good for us, and we should try to eat at least one portion of oily fish a week. What makes the oil fish such a superpower? Well, that's easy, because most of the oil fish are wild fish. They are very trained to survive in the wild, and they are very fast, and they are very agile, and they do want the best of the nutrition. So the best of the nutrition is given to them in the forms of EPA and DHA. Okay, let's say you cannot eat oily fish for whatever reason. Can you take pills? Can you take DHA and EPA pills? Well, the short answer is no. One, because they are expensive, and second is that because we don't have a concrete scientific evidence that the pills are actually working, that EPA and DHA, when it is isolated, when it is outside the food structure, the oily fish structure, and it's just isolated and given to you orally via a tablet, then they don't have the same effect as what they would have if you would consume the fish on its own. The association between EPA and DHA pills and improved health is not as clear as it is for fish. So always it's important to look at the big picture. And the big picture in nutrition is that the food should be consumed whole. And if you do try to create supplements for everything and then let them out of their original matrix and put them in a new matrix, isolates, then they are not working in the same way. it is like an orchestra. In an orchestra, you need the full swing. You need all the instruments for it to play well and to sound well. If you have only a few instruments, it wouldn't sound well. If you must take supplements, choose a fish oil or an omega-3 supplement. Don't choose fish liver oils. Cod liver oil is not the best source of omega-3 because on the top of the little omega-3 that it gives you, it has a lot of vitamin A, unnecessarily high levels of vitamin A that you probably don't want that. Aim to get 500 milligrams of DHA and EPA, which is equivalent to 140 grams of fresh oily fish. Omega-3 pills hardly work, and this is because they are oxidized in the digestion system. So we have two options. We have either increase our pill intake, which is, to be honest with you, not very practical to eat 6-7 pills of omega-3 per day, or to eat more fish, but there is an element of sustainability there, or to abandon, I guess, the pursuit of getting as much omega-3 in our diet as we can, and abandon, perhaps for some of us, eating fish altogether. If you got value out of this video, let me know down in the comments, click the like button, consider subscribing, and also hitting the notification bell for more important information around diet and nutrition coming up to you very shortly.